YouTube. This is my wrap up for August. I took part in the Draconathon and the Nostalgiathon. I didn't get to the History Challenge, unfortunately. But I managed to read 13 books, novellas, short stories, and I'm going to talk about them now. The first book that I read was In the Vanisher's Palace by Aliette Bodard. This was pitched as a FF Vietnamese retelling of Beauty and the Beast, and I gave it 5 stars. However, I absolutely adore this, this premise of this scholar being basically bartered off to this dragon in order to be a nanny or a governess. However, I feel like pitching it as like an FF, Beauty and the Beast, makes it sound like a romance, and for me it isn't. I really liked the relationship, but I don't feel like it was the central core or the central pillar to the story. I felt that had a lot more to do with the kids. So it wasn't what I expected. I think it was better than what I was anticipating, but just very much not what I thought it was going to be. Afterwards, I read the graphic novel Always by Yumi, Yamamoto and illustrated by Danni, and I originally did not rate this because I was very unsure. So I have heard a lot about this, and I also am subscribed to Yumi, Yamamoto. What I heard was that this was very surprising, and you know, someone really loved it and said every time I read this I get something new out of it, and I thought, well, this sounds really interesting. And I saw what was coming. I understand that different people find, you know, different tropes and things common or uncommon as according to their interests, but I felt like I'd seen this before, and I felt like it was obvious and kind of basic. And I'm also, you know, like my last upload was about art books. I am very kind of snobby. If something isn't like visually appealing to me and it's like a comic or a graphic novel or animation, then I tend not to want to put the effort in. So on a lot of levels it just didn't really work for me. I ended up giving it 4 stars, however, because I think it was very well done, and the art wasn't bad. Like, it wasn't categorically bad, it wasn't objectively bad, it just wasn't to my taste. So yeah, I still didn't really enjoy it, but it was good. And then it was the short story, If at First You Don't Succeed, Try Again by Zensho. This was a reread, so it was 5 stars. I really love it. It is about this Inugi who wants to ascend to dragonhood and fails again and again, and it is beautiful. It is really pulls on my heartstrings, you know, enough to make my eyes water. And I really loved going back and rereading it for the readathon, but I also went back and reread it because I think it was a few months after this was released that A Coda was released. However, that wasn't on Goodreads at the time. It has since, you know, been uploaded to Goodreads, so I decided I would read them both back to back. And while I don't think the Coda was necessary, I think I gave that 4 stars. It was good, and I did kind of enjoy the next step, but you don't succeed, try again worked really well as a standalone, and it didn't need a coda. But like I said, I enjoyed them both. After that, it was Histoire de Babar, the story of Babar, by Brunhoff, I think that's how you say it. And okay, yeah, I get it. You know, this has kind of been, it's problematic. I remember someone saying, you know, one of the reviews years and years ago, like being shocked at the content. And first of all, people are not passive receptacles. Like, if you think critically, you know, like you're. People are not passive receptacles, and secondly, you can talk to your kids. But I love elephants. Like, I have an elephant the size of a bin bag, and I have had Bump since I was like 3, and I do actually have a bin bag full of plushed elephants and more in my bedroom. And like little statuettes and figurines on my windowsill, and my bed sheets are elephants, and I suck at French. I took like 8 years of like at school French, and I can't read this. I would love to be able to read this, but I can't. I can read about 3/4 of this, and yeah, so I love elephants, and this is about my fluency level, so that's why I read these books. And by these books I mean I did read books 2 and 3 as well, and I know what I said about, you know, like, people are not passive receptacles. There was like a colonialist reading of this, and it is so unsubtle. I kind of don't think it was unintentional, but I'm kind of fine with that, because like I said, I know what it is. The second book, I hate it so much. And the third book, I could not understand even half of it, which was absolutely not helped by the author's handwriting. I don't know why they've gone with that kind of font. It makes it so hard to read, but just like vocabulary wise, it's getting harder and harder with every book, which is really frustrating. But, you know. So yeah, this was a really interesting kind of test to see how far I have fallen, and yeah, I don't think I've gotten that much worse since my hires, but I also haven't improved any, so. Then it was The Nose by Nikolai, Gogol, the Wilkes translation. I bring that up because it's kind of important. We read this for Romancing the Gothic, the book club, and it was fantastic and also kind of gutting again. Like, I had chronic fatigue, and I don't know whether I still have it, it's up for debate. And also depression, and in these COVID times, everyone is so run down and exhausted, and I was just barely conscious for most of it, which is a shame, because there was this talk, this Romancing the Gothic lecture on Russian Gothic and the fantastic, I think, and it was so good, and The Nose is just so absurdist and surreal, and we had these amazing smart people in this book group, and they were presenting all these readings of it that were just kind of mind-blowing, and I loved hearing them, and I cannot remember a single one of them. And also the person who runs Romancing the Gothic does know Russian, and so there was like a list of pros and cons of various translations, because the Wilkes translation doesn't seem to be much liked, and I was definitely not taking in anything by that point. I do not remember ever getting to that point, which is a shame, because I really like the idea of comparing translations, especially because it's a short story and rather than like a whole text, and comparisons would be easier that way. But you know, as much as I like loved the sound of all of these readings, I actually really like taking it at face value. Like, that just delights me. It is just so absurd that I love just taking it as is. Like, yes, this happened. This absolutely happened. And it happened exactly as it was said. it's just so weird. Yeah, I really enjoyed it. I did not rate it, I don't think, because of the translation thing. But I would really love to see more of that. I downloaded Lullaby for a Lost World by Aliette, and I don't know if this was for the Draconathon, but I definitely ended up talking about this in the Discord chat, because someone had read her Dragon's Feast Murders and weren't quite sure about it, but were interested in the series, and frankly that's kind of my entire opinion of the piece, that it is like The House of Shattered Wings, but darker. And I absolutely loved it. It is, The House of Shattered Wings is my absolute favourite book from Aliette de Bodard, and I was just in love the entire time. It's really, yeah, it is really dark, so I don't know what that says about me, but I just thought it was amazing. Also, yes, if you are interested in the Dominion of the Fallen series, I would say that this is a really great way to see if the series is for you, bearing in mind that the short is darker. And then was Northanger Abbey, and I hated the narrator. As a choice, I just absolutely hated it. The voice in general just was not working for me, but the voices for the characters, I'm not going to say it was nails on a chalkboard, but I don't think it was far off. And just like the voices, like, are you taking this seriously? Like, I hated it so much. I hated it so much. But we're gonna put a pin in that because Northanger Abbey is a pick for next month, for October, for the book group. So we will see if I do actually like it or not. I do think I might, but it was just, we will see. Fallen Angels, War Torn Paris, Revenge, and Murders, and Politicking, and The House of Shattered Wings reread. Yes, this is still my favourite in the series so far. I haven't read the last book yet. It is amazing. It is gothic and dark fantasy and murder mystery. There are so many genres and it pulls them off perfectly, and I love it. Like, I really don't think I can go into like any more detail without like just gushing, but this is one of those ones where I was saying it was my favorite, one of my favorite series ever. Before I was even like a third of the way through the first one. And so far I have been proven absolutely correct in this assertion. And I just love it so much. Then it was Robbergirl by St. Gibson, which I actually started April 29th. This was a pick for the Romance and the Gossip Book Club, and I loved it. But I kind of did not finish it in time, and then I kind of just was like rushing to do other readathons and to keep up with the book group, and it just kind of fell to the wayside. But I finished it, and that end, it was spectacular. Robbergirl is a sapphic retelling of the Snow Queen. It is about Gerda and the Robbergirl princess, and it is so good. It is very, very slow. It is basically slow right up until the point where they are facing the Snow Queen. It was very character driven. You got to see their relationship progress as they like slowly unravel each other and their pasts and come together. And then that end, it is gorgeous. It is such a gorgeous book. And like, I really want to say, you know, it's great and I want everyone to read it, and I don't think everyone would like it because it is so, so, so up until that last bit. Slow and introspective, and I don't know how popular that kind of mode of storytelling is. But yes, it was so good. It's gorgeous, and there is, I think next year this author has another book coming out, and I was so excited for that as well. And then we finished up with another read for the Draconathon, which was The House of Binding Thorns, and I was really surprised. This is where the murder husbands from where dragons, feasts and murders come in. This is where they meet, and oh my god, it's so good. This one was so much more concentrated in the Dragon Kingdom under the Seine, because that is a thing that is absolutely awesome. And House Hawthorne, I loved it so much. We didn't really see our Silver Spires. They got like a cameo, and Philippe wasn't as prominent, but we got Beryl and I think Francois, and just the Hawthorne trees. I spent quite a bit of us wanting to scream when we got to the Hawthorne trees. It's, oh my god, it's so good. And I did not expect it to take a turn. The series, I didn't really expect. I kind of thought it would be a much more linear progression from the first book, and in a way, you know, like it is linear, but thematically it takes a turn. And I commented this when I, on my like, this is the list of books that I read this year thread, Aliette Bodard actually quote retweeted me, and you know, was like, she said that the first was a claustrophobic mystery, the second was conflicting politics, and you know, the third, and I may have had to lie down. Like, I have spent so much time on Twitter being like, it is amazing that like the book community actually like talks to authors, and I really want that for myself. I really want to like talk to authors and get like sponsorships and be like a rep, and I haven't done any of these things. And I think this is, you know, why, because I like have to go and lie down anytime anything like this happens. But yes, I loved this as much as I loved the first one. Also, this book comes with a section at the back called Further Reading, and that is heaven. That is absolute heaven. So of the 13 that I read, less, just under half were short stories. Just over half, if you count the Babar books, and I probably do. But I still think it was a pretty good month, all things considering. And I hope that your reading was and is going well.